Thank you so much. Now, good afternoon, family, friends, and loved ones. This day of love has arrived. So, take pictures. That's great. Don't forget, keep your cell phones down so we don't hear any noise. That'd be great. Thank you. We gather here on this magnificent day and at this beautiful location to celebrate the wedding of Sheila and Paul. You have come here to share in this formal commitment that they make to one another, to offer your love and support to this union, and to allow Sheila and Paul to start their married life together, surrounded by the people dearest and most important to them. So welcome, one and all, who have traveled near and far, Sheila and Paul, thank you for your presence today. And now ask for your encouragement and lifelong support for their decision to be married. Sheila and Paul, marriage is perhaps the greatest and most challenging adventure of human relationships. No ceremony today can create your marriage. Only you can do that through love and patience, dedication, perseverance, through talking and listening, helping and supporting, and believing in each other, through tenderness and laughter, through learning to forgive, learning to appreciate your differences, and by learning to make the important things matter and to let go of the rest. What this ceremony can do is witness and affirm the choice you make to stand together as life mates and partners. We've come to the point of the ceremony where soon you're going to be saying your vows to one another. But before you do that, I ask you to remember that love, which is rooted in trust and mutual respect, will be the foundation of an abiding and deepening relationship. No other ties are more tender. No other vows are more sacred than those you now assume. If you are able to keep these vows that you take here today out of a desire to love and be loved by another person fully, without limitation, then your life will have joy. And the home you establish will be a place in which you both will find the direction of your growth, your freedom, and your responsibility. Folks, Sheila and Paul have chosen rings as outward symbols of the commitment they made here today. From the earliest times, the ring has been a symbol of wedded love, an unbroken and never-ending circle that symbolizes a commitment to love that is also never-ending. So Nick, if you'll hand me your ring here. Sheila, will you take this ring and please place it on Paul's finger? And say to him these words: this ring, a gift for you.
This ring, a gift for you.
Symbolizes my desire.
Symbolizes my desire.
That you be my husband.
That you be my husband.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
And I, Sheila.
And I, Sheila.
Take you, Paul, to be my husband.
To have and to
hold. From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
And I promise to you.
And I promise to you.
That I will show you my new clothes.
I will show you my new clothes.
Only during the commercial breaks.
Only during the commercial breaks.
Of golf. And football games on TV.
And I promise
that I will love you with all my heart.
That I will love you with all my heart.
Even those days when you play 36 holes.
Even those days when you play 36 holes.
And I will love you for richer or poorer.
I will love you for richer or poorer.
As long as our credit limit stays high. Until death do us part. Well done. All right, Paul. If you will take that ring that you have selected and place it on Sheila's hand and say to her these words: this ring is a gift for you.
This ring is a gift for you.
Symbolizes my desire that you be my wife from this day forward. And I, Paul, take you, Sheila, to be my wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, in sickness and in health. Whether the Broncos are winning or losing, to always file joint tax returns with the promise of future tax exemptions. For us to both love until death do us part. Let these rings serve not as locks, binding you together, but as keys, unlocking the secrets of your hearts for each other to know, and thus bringing you closer together and together forever. Sheila and Paul, having witnessed your vows, for marriage with all of those folks, friends and family that are assembled here today, by the authority vested by the great state of Texas and Colorado, I announce with great joy that you're a husband and wife, and you may seal your vows with a kiss. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my honor to introduce to you for the first time, as husband and wife, Mr. and Mrs. Paul and Celia Jones.